Namaste, my fellow strikers. Holy Materia here, back with another Shinobi Striker video. Today, we're going to be talking about how to play range, so let's get right into it. Before we start, be sure to like and subscribe if you enjoy content like this, and if you want to help support the channel, you can check out the merch options, just follow the link in the description. And this video has been done in collaboration with NordVPN, more about them at the end of the video. Since there's lots of new players in Shinobi Striker right now, I decided this is a great time to update all my class guides. Range right now is the hardest class to play and the worst class in the game probably, so I wanted to do this one first. So yeah, let's jump right into it. So we'll start on combat. So because the range class is a damage class, your main priority is doing damage and getting kills. Range class has lots of high DPS, so along with attack type, you're the best class at doing damage. And you also want to make sure you're finishing off people who are low on health. Since you have range moves, it's easiest for you to finish off people who are trying to get away. So that's the obvious part of the range class, is you're doing damage, getting kills. But like I said, range is the weakest class right now, so they have the lowest health pool. They have the least defensive abilities. We still don't have any jutsu that can heal ourselves. So number two, and maybe this could even be number one, is to don't die too much or to be cautious. Because the main mistake I see with new range players is that they go in playing range and they're just focusing on getting lots of kills, but they die like four or five times, and that doesn't really help your team. Like, even if you have six kills, if you die five times, it's not really beneficial to your team, because not only are you giving the other team kills, but you're also feeding them like their ultimate charge and stuff like that. So for range types, you have to be very cautious how you play. It doesn't mean that you always have to play from a distance, but just be careful. Because range types have the lowest health pool, they're one of the first targets for the enemy team. So the enemy team will usually focus the healer first and then the range type, or sometimes they might even focus the range type first if the healer is really evasive. So yeah, definitely be careful. And to go along with being careful, make sure you work on your movement. So you can check out this advanced movement guide, or check out an advanced movement guide from somebody else, because there's lots of these on YouTube. So the biggest thing is to learn how to cancel your landing animation. So to do that, just push the chakra jump button right as you land, and you can push the jump button at the same time to jump right out of it, or you can dash out of it. You can do all kinds of stuff out of it. Definitely check out an advanced movement guide if you're new to the game, and that's the most important thing, is practicing your movement. That will help you get to the level of the more advanced players. Because once you're pretty good with range class, you should only die like maybe once or twice, and that's usually like to ultimates. Once you know how to play and you know advanced movement and everything, and you have the right mindset, yeah, your range types shouldn't die that many times in a match. So going along with the being cautious thing, you need to know when to disengage from a fight. Like, usually in this game and in fighting games in general, like, I have this honor code of not running from a fight, but you need to know when it's just time to run, especially as a range type, since you have low health and you don't have very good self-healing options. So sometimes you just need to disengage from a fight and go back to your healer. It's the best thing to do for your team. So know when to disengage and just have a cautious mindset while you're playing. It's the most important thing for range types. You can really tell like when a range type is new, when they're just being reckless and just throwing out all their stuff and trying to do as much damage as they can and not being cautious. Like, you can see like, oh, this must be a new player that's playing range, because they're not really playing the right way. So yeah, so know when to disengage from a fight, but then also learn how to kite. So there's a difference between running and kiting. So when you run, you're just disengaging, you don't want any more smoke, you're getting out of there. But when you kite, it's when you keep your opponent at an advantageous distance from yourself. So because range types are range types, we have abilities that we can use at a distance. So you want to maintain a certain distance from your opponent where you can attack them, but they can't attack you. Or you can attack them effectively and they can't attack you as effectively. So basically, that range is the distance that your heavy attack will go, the kunai that you throw when you push triangle or whatever the heavy attack button is on your platform. So try to maintain that distance so that you can still do damage to your opponent, but they can't really mess with you. And to help you kite, learn how to do the kunai combo. People call this kunai spam, and some people frown on it, but it's fine to do. It's just a combo that range types have. So basically what you have to do is push the heavy attack button, and then you can cancel, and then push it again, and then cancel again. So first you want to jump, and then push the heavy attack button, then jump again, push the heavy attack button, then you can dash in the air, then push the heavy attack button again, and that's how you get your normal cancel. But you can also mix in your ninja tool. So especially if you have Senbun, Every time you throw a send button, that will also cancel it, and you can use the triangle button again after that. So you can throw all kinds of kunai. And when you're doing the kunai spam, make sure to mix in the charge attacks to stun your opponent, and then you can kunai spam them, or you can use that to set up close range combos. But I prefer to use kunai spam just so I maintain that good distance, because range types don't have very high damage on their close range attacks. But yeah, so mix in that charge attack, and then you can go in and do your kunai spam. And it's really effective against like new to intermediate players, but it's not that great against advanced players. They know how to get away from it. But the Sinbun are crucial no matter who you're playing against. So be sure to use those wisely, because you can use those defensively and offensively, like especially to keep like attack and defense types away from you, because they can't charge through that. Like you can charge through the heavy attack button, but you can't charge through a Sinbun with a charge attack. So yeah, those Sinbun are your best friend. But the other ninja tools are good too. Just experiment with what you like the best. Now, once you've mastered the basics, be sure to check out Hidden Rose's channel for more advanced range guides and just learning how to play range in general. Like, he's the one who taught me how to play range when I first started, because when I first started the game, range was the class I wanted to play because I just enjoy range type classes in most games. But I was dying all the time until I found Hidden Rose's channel and like learned how to play range and play it in a better way. And also, when I play range, I usually play from like a medium distance, like I talk about in this video here. But Rose is really good at playing range type from a close distance. So if you'd rather play range from a closer distance, then yeah, definitely check out Hidden Rose's channel for that too. Okay, so now let's talk about some of the ninjutsu and ultimates. So this is the thing that needs to be updated, because most of the stuff that I talked about here, we also covered in the last video. First, since there's lots of new players, let's talk about some non-DLC stuff. So recently, range types have gotten a lot of their base game jutsu buffed. Flame Bomb got a really good buff recently. You can throw out two. There's two stocks of it now, so it's really great. Phoenix Flower Jutsu locks subs. So the Scarlet Claw that you get from the Itachi VR Master. And these are all really easy jutsu to use too. Like just the fireballs in general are good. All the fireballs are really good. And they're also easy to use. And now all the Amaterasu moves lower your opponent's defense. And that's crucial. So things like Flame Formation and Amaterasu that you get from Itachi. And then also like size moves are good for beginners. And Deidara's moves are good too. And then for ultimates that are non-DLC, my favorite ult is Totsuka Blade on combat. So the move might seem like it's hard to hit, but if you use your charge attack to stun your opponent first, especially using the Kusanagi sword as your weapon, then the hit stun lasts for long enough for you to pop the ult, and the first part also hits your opponent. So it's a two-part ult, even though you don't put two inputs. So when you first do it and it comes up, that has a hitbox and it will hit your opponents, and it will one-shot most classes besides defense type. And then it will do the flaming sword, and then the flame will come out, and that's the second part. So if you can charge at your opponent and stun them, then that will give you enough time to do the first part and hit them. Once you get really good at it, you can charge your opponent, stun them, and then switch your target, and then the stunned opponent will get hit by the first part, and then the flame will go towards somebody else. So yeah, it's a really good ult once you learn how to use it. Kirin can be good, especially when you are comboing it with your teammates ultimates or whatever kind of stun that your teammates can do. But yeah, when it comes to ults, you can experiment and see which ones you like the best. But those are two really good non-DLC ults for range types. Now, if you're really serious about playing range and you want to start getting some of the DLC, the first one you should probably get is Adult Sasuke and Madara. Those are the two best range types. So Adult Sasuke overall is the best DLC. So he's got his flame lightning is one of the best moves in the game. It's great on combat. You can use it to extend combos. It's easy to get off usually. And then the Heavenly Hand Power can be used to set up all kinds of unique builds by swapping opponents into things like ultimates or ceiling tags and all kinds of stuff. But still, the best range move in the game is Majestic Destroyer Flame. So the Madara DLC is really crucial. Majestic is just such a good all-around move. It's good on every game mode. Does all kinds of damage. It catches people on fire. It's unblockable. It breaks sand shield water pillar. So yeah, this is probably the best range move still. The Double Shutting Gun Kakashi DLC is still good. It's not as great on combat, but the ultimate is really good. And Kamui Lightning Blade lowers defense, so that's good. But now there's lots of other moves that lower defense, so that's not as important as it used to be. He comes with Kamui, so you can play more defensively. Also, now, even though range types don't have any ninjutsu or ultimates that heal them, now there are lots of ninja tools that can heal. So if you're having a hard time surviving as a range type, you can try one of the medicine ninja tools that will heal you. So now range types have some self-healing options, but we still don't have any ninjutsu that heal. So that's why you still got to be cautious. But besides that, the clothing perks in general, I like to use First Blood to get my ult faster in general, and also Clear Mind so that I get my ninjutsu back faster. And then as my accessory, I almost always run Battle Hardened so I get health back every time I get a kill, because it's another way that ranged types can self-heal, even though we don't have self-heal in ninjutsu. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the basics on for range on combat. So the biggest takeaway is just to be cautious and don't be reckless while you're playing so you don't die too much. Okay, so now let's talk about base. So in base battle, like in all the game modes, for range types, still focus on getting kills, but it's nowhere near as important on base as it is in combat. So don't lose focus on the bases. Like, you still need to concentrate on making sure you guys are capping bases, because this is an objective-based game mode. So to help me capture bases and hold bases, I like to use the C2 Dragon, which is still one of the best summons in the game, and it's still the best summon for range types. But the Salamander is better than it used to be when I made the last video, so that one is viable now too. Majestic is almost a must on base battle for range types, especially because it breaks Water Pillar and Sand Shield. But if you don't have Majestic and you got in the fire style scientific ninja tool, that also breaks Sand Shield and Water Pillar. So yeah, but the reason I love the C2 Dragon is because it's like having another player with you on the base, and you can also leave it at one base to help your teammates and then go on to another base, because that's another thing that range types need to do on base battle, is to rotate. So because range types are one of the fastest classes, it's easiest for them to get around to the different bases. Like, knowing when to rotate and how to rotate will come with experience, but when I play, I usually like to capture my home base and then the B base, and then as a range type you can go to the enemy base to try to put some pressure on them and hassle them and sometimes range types just go straight for the enemy base before doing anything, and you can just hassle the opponent, and even if you don't capture it, just make it take longer for them to get the base, or just by you being there, it forces at least one other person to stay at that base with you so they can't help at B, which is where the big first team fight will always be at B base. So yeah, but in general, when it comes to rotating, just never leave your healer alone at a base, because the healer needs to be going around to support people. So if you see that your healer is at a base by himself, then you can rotate there, or just pay attention to like what's going on. Like, if you see somebody taking your base, you're the fastest one with the attack type, so you can go over there and help at wherever whoever needs help. So on base battle, because it's based on objectives, the ninjutsu and ultimates that are good are completely different. So like, a lot of stuff that's not really viable in combat is much better in base battle. So first of all, the summons are a million times better on base than they are in combat. So the summoning Salamander and the C2 Dragon work great on base battle. You can use Chikishoto if you have the DLC to like sneak around to the different bases, and Nagato's other move, the Shirado, is really good on base because that also breaks Sand Shield and Water Pillar. And the one is area focus, so you can just like shoot it at whoever's on the base to get them off. So that move is much better in base battle. Amaterasu is great because it's easier to land, and you can put it on the base where somebody is, and then it will also act as like a CC to keep people away from that area. Anything that will knock people away from the base, like Data's Clay Birds with the explosion, and anything that will be stationary and like that you can use to help control the base is good on base battle. And then for ultimates, my favorite alt on base battle since the game first started has been Susanoo Flame Control. So that is basically a free cap when you use it, unless you're going against like an advanced team or somebody that knows how to counter it, like getting an Explain Splat, or like that knows how you can move it, but there's only a few ways you can move it. So that's good. Even giant flame bombs can be good on base since people are standing still, and stuff like Tobirama's ult can be good. So a lot of like the stationary things, they work really well on base battle when they wouldn't really work that great on combat. Okay, so now let's get into flag. So this will be broken into two parts, like how to run the flag and how to defend the flag. So first, like every other game mode, range types should be focused on getting kills because it gives you ticks on the flag, and the more ticks you get, the easier it is to take the flag from your opponent. So like always, still get kills. So if you want to run the flag, there's lots of good ninjutsu now for range types. We're almost as good as attack types at running the flag at this point. At this point in the game, every class has good flag running builds. When the game first came out, it was pretty much flag running was the job of the attack type, but now anybody can do it. So if you want to run the flag, Chikishoto is great. Kamui, all the lightning blade Chidori type moves are really good. Hiding an Ash Jutsu, Angelic Advent, there's all kinds of stuff that range types have. And also the Flash Medicine Ninja Tool also is great at helping you run flags, and the new one that makes you invisible. And remember that if you use the move like Chidori or lightning blade on a wall and you go past the edge of the wall, then they will fly high up in the air, so you can use those moves vertically also, and the high ground is super important when you're playing in flag battle. It's not as useful as it used to be because now we have the vertical chakra jump, but it goes way higher than the vertical chakra jump. Yeah, having that high ground is really important, especially like if you can get yourself to the flag and you're like very high vertically above it, because that drop is so fast that a lot of stuff won't even be able to hit you, or people won't even notice you, and you can just drop down to the flag and without your opponents really being able to do anything to you. So it's almost like having another ninjutsu, just the dropping down. If you're running the flag, make sure to have on the clothing perk in a flash for your bottom skill, because that will basically make it so that when you have the flag with you, you're just running at your normal speed, and it's really crucial. When it comes to defending the flag, Flame Lightning is probably still the best flag defending jutsu in the game, because as long as you can see them, you can pull them, and since they go in the barrel animation, it will knock the flag out of them when they get hit by it. Water Dragon is really great because it has great distance and it has really good tracking now, and it goes through walls, so you can hit people when they get away with the flag, or you can hit people while they're running the flag. If you want to focus on defense, it's good to have a Sand Shield Water Pillar Breaker, because lots of times people will try to put Water Pillar or Sand Shield on the flag and then take it like that, or to help their teammates take it. Yeah, and as far as ultimates, it's kind of like base, where you can run in any alt that is stationary, like Toby Rama's ult to put on the flag base, and then you can blow everybody up and then take the flag, or you can use it to defend your flag. You could also use something like Adult Sasuke's ult to help you carry the flag, but it's not really necessary, so I wouldn't use that just for that. But yeah, that's pretty much it for flag battle. And then for barrier, if you play barrier, when you're attacking the boss, just use like ranged jutsu so you can attack the boss from a safe distance. And if you're defending the boss, just use basically like the kind of build that you would use on combat, because you're just going to be focusing on getting kills. But yeah, barrier battle is not something that anybody in the community really takes seriously. So you can just kind of experiment and have fun with it, as much fun as you can have in barrier battle. But yeah, so that's how to play range for the beginners. I hope this guide was helpful. And like I said, if you want some more advanced tips, then be sure to check out Hidden Rose, because he's the best range main in the Shinobi Striker community. So yeah, be sure to check him out. But yeah, I hope this video was helpful, guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that like button. And if you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. And if you want to help support the channel, you can check out the new Holy Materia merch. Link's in the description. And this video has been done in collaboration with NordVPN. You can get an exclusive NordVPN deal if you follow my link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. I use NordVPN whenever there's a game or a streaming service that's not available in my country, because you guys know I live in the Philippines, but it also offers amazing cybersecurity. But yeah, check that out if you want to help support the channel. Appreciate you guys. See you in the next one. Everybody stay safe out there. Peace and love.